previous lesson, we learned about communicable or contagious diseases and how they spread from person to person. This lesson will focus on how to avoid catching these diseases in the first place. There is an old saying, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, which basically means that it is much easier to prevent illness than it is to treat it. Prevention means to keep something from happening or existing. In this lesson, you will learn that there are some very simple steps you can take to prevent disease and keep yourself and your community healthy. One of the best ways to prevent the spread of germs and disease is to practice good hygiene. One of the most common ways that disease-causing germs are spread is through hand-to-hand contact and in the air when someone coughs or sneezes. An uncovered cough or sneeze can spray germs up to 10 feet. Defend your friends and family by covering your mouth and nose with a tissue if you cough or sneeze. If you don't have a tissue, it's best to cough or sneeze into the crook of your elbow rather than leaving the cough or sneeze uncovered. After coughing or sneezing, it is important to wash your hands. For a thorough clean, wash your hands with soap and warm water for at least 15 seconds. Don't forget to scrub the backs of your hands, between fingers, and under fingernails. It is also important to wash hands before and after preparing or eating food, after using the restroom or changing a diaper, after handling garbage, before and after treating a cut or wound or tending to a sick person, after touching a pet or other animal, and before you do any activity that involves putting your fingers in or near your eyes or mouth. In addition to practicing good hygiene, another good way to prevent disease is to stay up to date on your immunizations. Immunizations or vaccines generally come in the form of an injection or oral drops. Vaccines are usually a dead or weakened strain of a virus that, when introduced to your body, promotes the production of antibodies. Antibodies allow your body to recognize the pathogenic strain of the virus if you happen to be exposed to it. In this way, vaccines give you immunity to certain diseases. If you are immune, your body is able to resist a virus when it attacks, and you don't experience symptoms of the disease. Additionally, you cannot spread it to other people. Immunizations, therefore, strengthen your immune system. Vaccines are administered on a schedule, an immunization schedule. You can check your immunization record with your school nurse, family doctor, or with your local state health department to make sure you are up to date with your immunizations. Another strategy for avoiding infection is practicing food safety techniques. The safety of your food is dependent upon proper storage and refrigeration and proper handling during preparation and cooking. Food can spoil or become contaminated if the food handlers are sick and breathe on food or fail to wash their hands before preparing food. Fecal matter can also contaminate food if the preparer fails to wash hands after using the restroom or touching animals. Foods left at the wrong temperature can spoil, so make sure that items requiring refrigeration stay cool. Foods can also spoil if they come into contact with certain other foods, like raw meat. When two foods touch and spoil, it's called cross-contamination. An example of cross-contamination would be if you used a knife and cutting board to cut raw meat, and then used the same knife and cutting board to prepare raw vegetables. The vegetables would be contaminated by the raw meat and could cause food poisoning if consumed. To avoid cross-contamination, be sure to wash hands, dishes, and utensils between preparing different types of food. The last strategy for preventing illness is to avoid risky behaviors. Many infections can be spread through body fluids, like blood, semen, pre-seminal fluid, breast milk, vaginal fluids, and rectal mucus. Engaging in sexual activity with multiple partners or failing to use protection such as condoms puts a person at higher risk for contracting sexually transmitted diseases. Some STDs, like chlamydia and gonorrhea, can be cured with antibiotics, but others, like herpes and HIV, are viral and cannot be cured. Someone who contracts herpes will live with it for the rest of their life. HIV is a virus that attacks the immune system and leads to AIDS. Hundreds of thousands of people die each year from AIDS-related illness, though emerging treatment options are making it possible for HIV-infected people to live longer than they did before. HIV can be contracted not only by sexual contact, but also through the use of illegal intravenous drugs. Sharing needles or using contaminated or non-sterile needles makes this behavior extra risky, and the chances of contracting blood-borne pathogens becomes even higher. Avoiding risky behaviors, like intravenous drug use and unprotected sex, can greatly reduce the likelihood of contracting diseases like HIV. Every day, our bodies are bombarded with potential pathogens in our surroundings. Our body's natural defense systems are designed to overcome these threats, but we can help to prevent illness and the spread of disease with these four simple strategies. Remember, it is easier to prevent illness than it is to treat or cure it.